My name is Oleg Larionov. I was born and raised in Russia, a country of snow, clean air, and excellent people. Most of my life has been devoted to learning martial arts, learning and trying to comprehend this cultural phenomenon that captivated hearts and minds of millions of people around the globe. And even though we are so different, with different thoughts and habits, different skin color and language, every evening small classes of Okinawa open their doors to the big and complex world of martial arts. Traditional Okinawa martial arts, the magical combination of words. Many things intertwine in them, harsh past, an impatient present, a kind smile, and at times frenetic desire to fully learn all your capabilities. It is a world of controversies that by a strange coincidence do not block each other, but complement, a world that makes you love more and more the unorthodox nature of that cultural phenomenon. It is my world. It is your world. It is a world of everyone who at least once stepped over the threshold of an Okinawa martial arts dojo. Welcome to my class, my family, Shōrin-ryū karatedo Kyudokan. It is one of the best and most known dojo of Okinawa. The style patriarch Minoru Higa-sensei is a great man and a great karate master. Seeing this luminous, smiling man makes you think of Buddha. His life is devoted to karate and everything who becomes his student becomes his son. It's hard to say what he would be like if there was no karate in his life. But one thing is for sure, karate has enriched his life path, added some amazing meetings and soulful partings, minutes of joy and an awful lot of hard work. Karate is not simple, but learning karate is worth all spent effort, sweat and blood. Kyudokan Dojo is filled with a spirit of history where many famous karate masters of today started their ways. It is a real symbol of live history, not only carefully kept by the Okinawans, but also accumulating the experience and knowledge of the past years, connecting craftsmanship of the old generations and today. A hospitable house surrounded by the green invites you to have a rest, opening a way to a future that is not at all simple, and it is only up to you whether you finish it or lose heart and walk away. First, I started judo since my first grade. That was when my uncle, Yutoku Sensei, said to me, "Maybe we should do some karate," to which I always replied, "Sorry, but no. I just didn't have time for that, you see, as all free time that I had, I gave to judo." So it turned out that before my university education began, I couldn't start karate. But my wish was very strong, and during summer holidays, after the second year of education, at the age of 18, I returned from Tokyo to Okinawa, and when I was proposed to start training, I couldn't say no anymore, and I entered Kyudokan. Shōrin-ryū Karate-do Kyudokan Dojo, as well as most training rooms of Okinawa, is in the master's house. In this case, the house of Master Yutoku Higa, the founder of the style. Changing with time, it never stopped adhering to traditions of Okinawan karate, brilliantly demonstrating the power of fists and force of spirit of his students. Higa Yutoku was one of the most prominent members of Okinawan society, an acknowledged authority both among karate masters and in political and cultural life of Okinawa Island. His integrity and openness in life were combined with harshness and immovability during class. Okinawa, its people and traditions were part of his life, the core of which was still karate. For Master Yutoku, it became not just a style of life, forging his soul and forming his character, but also a duty to his teachers and generations of masters who made this way possible. The art of Kyudokan was founded by Master Matsumura Sokon, after whom there was Tibana Choshin, then there was Higa Yutoku, and only then there was me. Before Matsumura Sokon, there were other masters, for example Sakugawa Kanga and some others, but they were not directly related to Kyudokan. Also worth mentioning is Master Itoshu Anko, who significantly influenced the formation of the style. But strictly speaking, Kyudokan began with Matsumura Sokon. When you come to Okinawa, it seems that the time has stopped. A settled, tranquil life, small quiet streets, and a stately shuri castle symbolizing centuries of controversial history of the island. But this impression is erroneous. Okinawa is a modern, dynamic island where everything can be found. Wise elderly wish to have fun and naturally quiet, romantic sadness. But the main distinguishing feature of the Okinawans is the ability to take life as it is. Perhaps there isn't another country in this world where I could see such a touching reaction when I pointed my camera to people. I often find myself thinking that maybe this is the reason for success of karate as a system, embodying simple things so very difficult for us Westerners. But it is to learn this that we come to the place where karate was born, isn't it? Not only to study karate, but to submerge into a world of Okinawan culture, kind and sincere people, to stop, look around, and believe that everything is going to be fine. Shōrin-ryū Kyudokan is not just one of the strongest dojo of Okinawa, but also one of the strongest organizations of Okinawa karate in the world. Countless students from all over the globe never stop coming to see and have a class with Master Minoru Higa. Argentina, France, Poland, Germany, Spain are developing the school of ancient Okinawan combat tradition. Being a student of Minoru Higa is a sort of a quality mark, the quality of karate mastership and universal values. Kyudokan is not just a world, it is a universe of knowledge, experience, communication and new impressions. But still, many people are wondering, what is karate? What is so special about this method? And how are these smiling, not exactly tall people are different from us? What force makes us come to the karate alma mater every year to remind us once again that karate is very simple and that's why it is so hard? But understanding doesn't mean mastering these simple principles that require hard work and took decades to form. Otsunahiki, which translates as Naha Giant Tug of War, is the greatest cultural event on Okinawa, with thousands of people representing teams of East and West pulling a 43-ton rope. Traditional Okinawan costumes, magnificent parade of 14 flags, it is a spectacle so grand and breathtaking that hardly there can be found another event in the cultural life of Okinawa that would so vividly demonstrate all the spirit, courage, and fortitude of the people of this little island. An amazing event, amazing show that I will tell you about in my upcoming films. Tradition. One of the prevailing and probably defining factors in the life of Okinawa and the answer to many questions. One of the central events of the Otsunahiki Festival is karate demonstration of 18 members of East and West. And it is not by chance that 3 out of 4 West team members are Kyudokan masters. It is for a reason that the school is proud of its bond with the origins of karate, permanence of many forms that came to us from the time immemorial, and profound understanding of detailed combat methods. For what some people are now trying to present as school secrets, only told about secretly, is in fact just some techniques that have always been handed over from teacher to student to form the correct understanding that is essential not only for the school, but for the karate system itself. Karate is not a secret, not a mystery, but hard work multiplied by knowledge, experience, and craftsmanship. The most important thing in karate is the art of controlling your body and namely your center of gravity, tanden. This is the toughest part. For example, arm movements, punches, blocks are like branches of a tree. They are countless. But unless you control your center, they are useless. So the most difficult is to learn to source your energy from tanden. Whether your hand in block is slightly higher or lower is of no importance if you use your body correctly.
Unfortunately, not all people understand these simple things, which is the reason for many people to misunderstand karate. The essence of karate is not brutal force and physical power, but knowledge and years of practice. People who are not connected with martial arts think that karate masters or students are like superheroes capable of wonders, whereas in fact it is a subject of much debate among the adepts, whether traditional martial arts are efficient against other combat systems that we know about from television. They provide the main thing, the show element, and the seeming efficiency which makes it impossible to understand its purpose and to see what's going on. They can easily overshadow traditional systems, making them look easy and boring. But one always has to remember, the essence of karate is this. Efficiency is in details. The tradition of karate schools came from the times when there was no virtual discussions about their effectiveness. It was all about one thing, winning. When I started practicing, I never thought that karate is for health or something like that. I thought, I'm gonna treat it like a hand-to-hand combat. Yes, now there are people who use karate for health, but it came with time. You see, the world is changing and people are changing. Everybody used to practice karate to become stronger, so the classes were very much different from what they are now. For example, no one did so much kata like now. It was more about basic exercises, punches, kicks, body hardening, movements, etc. There was very little kata. That's why there used to be many people who didn't know and didn't understand kata, only older students. Others could just watch them. Today, everybody knows about kata, but not everybody understands what karate is as a hand-to-hand combat. Yes, karate does change so that anyone who comes to the class could practice. Izumizaki District, Naha. Here is the location of a home dojo of Minoru Higa-sensei. Every Saturday morning, classes take place here. And after one of those, Higa-sensei agreed to show elements of Shōrin-ryū Kyudokan as a combat system. Kakie, the pushing hands, the essentials of a hand-to-hand combat. In theory, kakie serves to develop sensitivity, so soft technique is used in training. Also, the notions of distance and moving skills are taught. But in practice, it is a free fight following set rules. During class, the students develop the skill to capture the initiative, which eventually leads to victory over the opponent. Fast, preferably right there. Kakie is used to practice the school techniques aimed at attack and counterattack. But one should not think that kakie may exist separately from Kyudokan. It is not a secret method, not a magic knowledge that helps you win any fight. It is just a path that leads the way, but it is your job to follow it. The secret of any success is about hard work, integrity, and selecting the right path. The kakie exercise, as well as other methodical practices, can be found practically in all Okinawan karate systems with some minor differences. But what makes the Kyudokan karate so special that it can be called one of the strongest systems on Okinawa? The main difference of Kyudokan from other Shōrin-ryū systems is that we pay special attention to direct punch. It started in the times of Yuchoku Sensei, and that was the only thing he practiced. Our system also includes tanren, body hardening, along with kicks and punches. It is very important to practice punches paying attention to all details to make it as powerful as possible. Besides, all students punch at makiwara and study basic techniques very carefully. But the foundation of all practice is tsuki. Every time I start working on a new film about traditional martial arts, I get the same problem. How do I show what traditional karate is? How do I take to the mind of a simple person sitting comfortably in a chair the full concept of persistence, fortitude, ability to nix compromises with oneself, but prevail over one's weakness, tiredness, to make oneself fight their inner self and ultimately to win? In case with many schools, it may not seem very difficult, but with Kyudokan, it is not exactly an easy task to create a visually dynamic story. We already know that the basis of the whole system is direct punch, tsuki. remember the main law. If you want to learn how to hit, hit. And they do in Hambo Dojo. This is the real trademark of Kyudokan. Deft to unprepared foreigners and overcoming oneself with every class. Now, of course, times have changed. But the tradition to spend most of the time on basic techniques lives on. Sometimes lines of students spend 30 to 40 minutes again and again making hundreds of punches until the vision becomes dark and the brain starts to fail. But you have to carry on because Minoru Higa-sensei stands in front of you and accompanies every punch with kime, 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 doing the same. Every punch, stronger, faster, smarter. And while for a spectator, those minutes may only seem boring, for those involved in the process, every class is a marathon with no right to back down. This is the only way that karate turns from a system of mere punches and kicks into an academy of strength and spirit, preparing the kind of people who know the value of the words I can. The true brotherhood of men and women with respect for one another. Heard a lot of times from karate specialists from all over the world that Kyudokan is great at hitting. And in the world of hits, this is a very valuable praise, and it's quite hard to get. During the film, I've talked a lot about the Okinawa Island tradition, the karate tradition that currently gets pushed out by the reality of today. That makes saving the Kyudokan system tradition ever more important. Not stepping down under the force of the wind of change, keeping the ways of laws that are not always clear. Initially, karate was signified with the word ti. Ti is a hand, not foot. There used to be a saying that feet are not to be lifted higher than hands, to be used against above the belt, and so on. Because if you get caught by the leg, you're going down, and if you're down, it is the end. Now there is no danger of death in a fight, so it makes no difference if you're down. If you're down, it only means you lost. It's only about winning or losing. In the older days, a fall in traditional karate meant death, so the fighter tried to act so that to avoid falling. It seemed perfectly simple, but one little thing changes everything. Tsuki is more important than kicking. Yuchoku-sensei said so, and I think so too. It would be wrong to think that Okinawan karate in general, and Kyudokan specifically, are so easy in their form. The ability to fight correctly is first of all about mastering your body, possessing an arsenal of techniques and practicing the little things, because, as the tradition has it, there is nothing little in a fight. Unlike many other styles of shorin-ryu, Kyudokan has a lot of circular techniques originating from Goju-ryu, a style whose founder, Master Chōjun Miyagi, trained Yuchoku Higa. Kyudokan has nothing against sharing and learning from other martial arts. Masters say that you cannot stand still, only constant learning and search for new can provide constant development. Interesting thing is that historically, the name Shōrin-ryū, which Kyudokan is part of, is written just like the famous Shaolin Monastery, the legendary cradle of traditional Oriental combat systems. Was it accidental or not, but watching the classes in Hombu Dojo, you realize that you moved centuries back to the time when martial arts were part of real life and had a very distinct purpose, to stand for yourself. Minimum movements, maximum results. It would be a mistake to think that the bigger the arsenal of the master, the better his karate becomes. But what have you got to do if you don't live on Okinawa? What principles do you have to observe in order not to let a dangerous and powerful martial art turn into a paper tiger? is it sufficient to exhaust oneself with numerous repetitions of movements and thousands of strikes? Will the practical karate be a heritage of decades of sanguinary labor and experience obtained by sweat and blood in Okinawan dojos? Difficult question. You could say that in Okinawan karate, all movements have a small amplitude, no excesses. For example, a block protects only the body, not the sides. All movements are like this, no big movements. The movements are small and built around the center of gravity, tanden. Nothing like that. From our point of view, big swings are pointless. Same as when you hit. Not even this tad bigger. The movement is tiny. You make the block or the strike from the position your hand is now. So the movements are short, done with your loins. Loins, loins, loins. If you don't practice with that way of thinking, it would be hard to understand Okinawan karate. If a person knows nothing about the karate principles, then the least he should think of is the movements protecting only the body. Don't put a block where there is nothing to protect. You will get confused and waste energy. So what is this fighting aspect in Kyudokan? As all traditional schools, Shōrin-ryū karatedo Kyudokan was created not for sport competitions, but for self-defense in the street. The main thing is to intercept the initiative. If you have the initiative, you have the opponent, and eventually victory. Distance. The closer you are to the opponent, the more concentrated your actions are, the less noticeable, and the more dangerous they are for the attacker. Remember, the source of your power is your center of gravity. The shortest distance to the goal is a straight line. Make your attack your defense. Be brave and decisive in your actions. Speed and precision are guarantee of your success. Martial arts are a set of potentially dangerous techniques to quickly stop the enemy, causing him grave damage. Those are the techniques that left the modern karate, but they still live in Okinawan schools. Sure, modern times are different from the age of warring states, and there is no need to fight every day. So the only application for karate is your personal growth. This is the knowledge of karate application that you need to go to practice with. Practicing for battles and practicing for something else is not the same thing. You have to ask yourself also, what would I like to become practicing karate? I would like to become stronger, etc. I think you have to practice with a specific goal, then you will progress. Speaking in general, I think there is no actual combat karate. Even styles that call themselves real karate have rules, and in reality there are no rules. So those real kinds of karate are more like competition karate. I am not an expert in this, but I still think that karate is not for real use. If we talk about real, there are other sports very strong besides karate, for example wrestling, where there are many strong people. I'm not even sure will a karate fighter win against such an opponent. So I think that karate is first of all hardening your body and spirit. Reality has other needs, to strike in the eyes, bite the nose and other things. Because there are no rules, and any real existing karate has rules. For quiet and tranquil Okinawa, the question whether karate is a martial art or just a physical cultural heritage like dance or music is basically not important. But for foreigners, the word karate is connected with, albeit theoretical, but still a capacity to use those skills in self-defense. One should also remember about the spirit of the martial arts celebrated in numerous books and films, which are often the first cause to start looking for a karate school. But seeing the true methods of karate, which are somewhat slow and subtle, the newbies get pretty much disappointed and often leave the dojo looking for more understandable ways for perfection. but such laconic way of teaching is the true essence of Okinawa karate as a cultural heritage. Spiritual development goes through physical improvement following the norms of the Japanese society and general teaching culture. You don't always blindly follow a dogma. You are to have a flexible, quick mind and a large experience to feel confident in any situation. Such form of teaching, mysterious and shrouded by many myths and legends, is what kata is. Kata translates as a casting form. According to many opinions, kata is the real treasure trove and the ABC of karate. It is hard to say if it's true or false, but one thing is for sure. Kata is the necessary and important part of the Kyudokan system that lets you better understand yourself and your abilities and try to unscramble the knowledge handed down from generation to generation. Every student has to improve their kata through internal work, letting the rhythm, plastics, and force of every element pass through them. And doing so in your own country requires competent, knowing teachers, who are not many in Kyudokan. But no one is rushing for cheap popularity and numbers in Kyudokan Dojo. People come here once and for all. A lot of foreigners coming to Hombu for classes that are not bypassers or sport tourists who come once in several years. They are constant and credit students of Minoru Higa, whatever their age, social status, and position is. You don't look for excuses in Kyudokan. It is love forever, love for labor, love and respect for the people around you, love for the culture that created this unique school. It doesn't matter whether a karateka is Japanese or a foreigner. The difference is not about nationalities, but personalities. Weakness can be found everywhere. I, for one, see a growing enthusiasm for karate classes among foreigners. It could seem that the people are the same, but Okinawans are not anything special physically, and foreigners are usually bigger and physically stronger, and their karate is stronger, so Okinawans have to practice at the top of their capabilities to match foreign students. Japanese are not evolving like foreigners, so the enthusiasm for class is different with the Okinawans and foreigners. Japanese may work hard, but again, foreigners are much more diligent, and this is their advantage. This is why I take foreigners, and my students are happy when they come. We practice together, an international exchange of experience and knowledge takes place. It's not just a class. Everybody is talking to each other, also in English and Spanish. You get an opportunity to see the big foreigners, the way they practice with strength. It is also part of the training. I think it is useful to watch different people. The students are happy, and that makes me happy. If the students told me they didn't want foreigners to practice with them, I might as well not take them. But my students like foreigners. Many people also come from other karate schools, including Shōrin-ryū and others. I welcome all of them. Okinawan Budokan. I guess there are few places in this world that are that much revered by the followers of Okinawan martial arts, irrespective of school. This is where the biggest competitions and festivals take place, showing all the beauty and power of karate. At the latest event, the delegation from Shōrin-ryū karatedo Kyudokan was more than impressive. Performance of women, people from different countries, common kata demonstration by students of different dojo. Such demonstrations happen quite often on Okinawa, but it's not every time that such an impressive number of style masters and patriarchs attend.
Okinawa Shōrin-ryū karatedo Kyudokan Tedo no kata wo ikimasu. Kojimen.
Pedro Fattore of Argentina is a prominent man. Ninth Dan, one of the first students of Minoru Higa Sensei. Only superlatives can be used when talking about this man. The true soul of Kyudokan. Excellent master, teacher, father. Knowing such a person makes life of everyone happier and brighter. One of the most prominent karate practitioners and people I have ever known in my life. During preparation of this film, I received dozens of messages from his students in Argentina containing one and the same question. When will we see the sensei? No other proof characterizing Pedro Fattore is needed. The foreigners coming to Japan are usually offbeat. They have something in them. They are attracted to our culture. They are inquisitive and very hardworking. They have a lot of things we can learn from them. As I said, it is important to exchange experience between different people. It makes us better, more tolerant, more intelligent. I think foreigners are very interesting. They do some things very well. Indeed, Kyudokan is one world, big and friendly, directed by one idea and one love. Karate has no boundaries, no age or social limits. It is a living tradition, no matter how banal and trivial these words may be. Whatever opponents of traditional martial arts say, karate continues to evolve. And, to be honest to the end, it happens largely to the foreign students. Their sincere thirst for new makes these sometimes not at all young people more like children who sincerely and with passion absorb new knowledge. They say that everything in life evolves along a spiral. And if it is so, then perhaps karate is the same and something new at the same time. For Okinawa is no longer a Ryukyu kingdom. Karate ceased to be a weapon and turned into a hobby for managers and clerks. But the indomitable spirit still lives in Okinawan dojo, stating with pride, times have changed, but the ancient heritage is alive and will live on. And it will bring many surprises to everyone who decides to cross the threshold of a dojo with sincere and open heart. For it is what Okinawa Island is, always ready to take anyone as they are, not labeling them and not trying to change them. Perhaps this is the part of the secret of Okinawan karate. This place itself and its people. And the main thing, they will continue to make this island the way they want to see it. And we will only have to stand and watch, and maybe help a little, but only when asked to. A city of Urasoe, home of one of the strongest Kyudokan dojo. It is headed by Nobuko Oshiro Sensei. With 8 dan, she is all but the only woman to have achieved such heights in the hierarchy of Okinawan karate. Over 200 children are in her class. Strict discipline and high technical standards go along with an open smile and sincere kindness of Nobuko Sensei. It is by far one more face of the precious stone of a big Okinawan tradition called Shōrin-ryū karatedo Kyudokan.
Hi, kids.
Speaking of Kyudokan karate, its features, traditions, techniques, nuances, and the people who come to class, it would be a big mistake not to think of its future. Of course, we can only guess and imagine what future it may have, but watching the classes Urasoe Dojo, seeing the courage and fortitude in small children overcoming all difficulties of the training, I believe that Okinawan karate has a future, and it is bright. The pace of modern life is faster. People are looking for quick results, money, love, and the thoughtful and tempered manner of traditional karate does not always fit in. One should admit that Okinawan martial arts today are not only a combat system, but more of an education of character, a science of overcoming one's weakness and laziness. karate becomes a form of meditation, a way to look inside yourself and try to find the answers to internal unresolved questions. But make no mistake, karate may be elegant and grand as a sword's sheath that still keeps the ancient and noble weapon that is always taken care of and always ready to protect the life and well-being of its owner. I guess it wouldn't be an exaggeration to say that the majority of foreigners coming to Okinawa are coming for classes at Karate Dojo. And it is the combination of special friendliness and openness of the island that makes karate so attractive, an undoubted contribution to understanding the integrity and uniqueness of the art of karate. Karate is more than just sports or physical education. It is a way of self-identification for the very people of Okinawa. Together with other traditional martial arts, it is an anchor that keeps the ways of life, thoughts, and cultural heritage. The long history of the island people has resulted in unique features of their life that still can be seen today. Karate of Okinawa cannot end with only a story of one karate school, not mentioning history, traditions, and modern life. And of those I will try to tell you in my next films of the series, for one cannot comprehend karate without trying to comprehend Okinawa. What is Okinawa? It is my country, my island, a place important for me, I guess the most important.
最も大切な場所ということ